Hello everyone, welcome to BIM Modeler. In this video tutorial, we will be learning under modify, all these modify tools we will be covering it. Also, how to rehost the existing element from one place to the another place. So if you like this video, share it with your learning friends and happy learning. I have also included this file to our website. You can download this and practice the basic modifying settings. With that, let's start. So your practice session will be on the top and solution how we are expecting on the bottom. So for example, a move command, shortcut for move, it is MV. You can give MV or you can use this symbol M. Select the element that you wanted to move and press enter. Or in either words, select the element first and select the command. Both the way it works. An important thing to notice in the move command and copy command, it is selecting the base point. For example, in this place we have to move this element to here, this middle. So it is important to know the snapping position. Before moving into this option, you have to learn about the snap and snap settings in Revit. Go to manage, you have a snap settings in this place, click that. There are different snapping settings as like in any other softwares and AutoCAD. So endpoints, you can give a short command as snap end, middle point snap middle, and the center of the circle, it is snaps center. These are the most commands that we use it. So if you wanted to learn more about these commands, you can come back and do it. Select this object, select the move command. We need to move it from this middle of this line, so select the middle and place it on the middle, as simple it is. We have to move it like this. The base point supposed to be in the corner so that we will be able to pick this corner. So move, select the base point in this place, and if you see that this element, it is not moving towards this corner. The reason is it is constrained. You can untick this constraint and move it to this place. In this case, you have to move this circle, the center position, to the corner of this rectangle. You have to take the command, and to select the center, you can come nearby that object or give snap settings, which is snap center, SC. You can press it, or you can right click on this object, snap override. You can specify as snap center. Select the circle, automatically the center point will be highlighted, and then you will be able to click the corner. That's it, move command. We can move ahead with the copy command. The copy command also similar to the previous one, until the one command which differentiate is that you can select it, this option. By default it will be in single element mode. So if you are selecting the center of the object, you will be able to copy only one time. For the second time, you have to go for the copy command again. If you want to do multiple times, you have to click this option, select it, place it in multiple places. The next option also very similar, and only thing is the base point location. Copy, multiple is selected in the option bar. Select the quadrant and you can select each corner. The option is done. So I ask you to practice this with all the, any other option that you have in mind. You can do that. And the next command will be rotate. So for example, we need a result like this. So we have to rotate it 45 degree center of the circle like this. So you can go ahead, select this element, take the rotate command. If you take the rotate command, by default the center position of the object will be placed. You can use this place option and place them in the center of the object like this, or you can simply drag it wherever you need it like this. Drag it to the center. Once it is done, you have to specify the starting place. From here it is 45 degrees. You can type 45 degrees in this place, or you can specify in the option bar. The second thing is that you have to create another object like this with the rotation of 90 degrees. You can go and select the rotate option, you can tick the copy option. Now by default it will be in the center of the object, so not a problem. You can click and you can enter 90 degrees in the angle. Similarly, this object, rotate, this time copy, and we have to place the base point in the corner of this place and rotate it 90 degrees. By using this, you must have understand all the options in rotate. Let's move on to the trim and extend command. The trim and extend commands are, there are three different options available in Revit. First one is trim and extend to corner, and the second one is trim and extend to the single element, and the third one is trim and extend multiple elements. Now we are going to practice the trim and extend. As like in AutoCAD you will have a two different commands, but in Revit the difference is that you have only one command for trim and extend. In AutoCAD you will be selecting the elements that you don't wanted, the corner that you don't wanted, but in Revit you have to select the element you needed. So for example, this corner we don't wanted, this corner need to be increased, this corner need to be removed. So we need this side, so select this side. We also need this side, select this side. Similarly, we need this side and we don't need the top side, so select this side. Similarly here, we need this, we need this, we need this, we need this. Here, if you wanted to make this shape, so we need this circle, this side, and this line like this. Try with the other side, we need this side and we need this side. Similarly to here, we need this, we need this. Here, we need this, we need this. As simple it is. So in while doing a trim and extend in Revit, you have to remember which side you needed. So this trim and extend, which is only for the corner of the object, you can use the shortcut as TR. The next option is trim and extend to a single element. For example, in this case, you have to extend the elements and trim the elements, some of the elements. Use the second option, or in this case, here. Take this. This object need to be extended till this end. So we have to pick this object first. This object will be extended. Similarly, you have to pick this, will be extended on the other side. Pick this till this object, and we need this object till from here to there, like this. On the multiple trim, multiple element trim and extend, you don't have to select multiple elements, because in this place you are selecting multiple times the same elements. For in this case, you can click this edge, so one element will be here and the other element will be here. You can press escape or click somewhere to deselect this object and click the second face, and you will be able to select multiple times of this object like this. It will be faster if you have multiple elements like this. So with that, trim and extend is completed. We can go back as say align command. The align command shortcut is AL. You can use this icon align, and if you are coming nearby this, we need to align this option. So even you can use the trim and extend to complete this option, but I will ask you to do this specific method. Reason is you can use align command for point also. Align first point, second point. And for this case, if you wanted to align with this line, you see that this line, so select the first line, select the second line. You have to select the second option as what object need to be moved. But in this case, this object need to be moved. So select the first line and this object need to be moved. So I'm selecting this as a second one. So the align command shows you lock symbol also. If you want, you can lock. The reason for locking it is the element will not split if you are trying to move the one element. The next command, it is offset. My favorite command. The offset symbol is this one. You can use OF as shortcut. And you have to specify offset value and do you need the copy of the element or not, or you can specify graphically if you need. I am going numerically here with 1000 offset value. 1, 2. You can use the trim and extend to finish it. This object needed, this object needed, so the unwanted element will be deleted. Use the offset again, OF, and 1000 again. So in this case, you are creating multiple object, a continuous object. You can use the tab key to select multiple object. Do remember, based on your cursor, it will go inside or outside. Which position do you need it? So cursor depends on the cursor position, so it will change. We need it outside, so click outside position. In this case, outside. In this case, inside. Tab can do like this, or make a outside tab like this. Tab it. That's it. So offset command, it is very easy. If you need to use offset graphical, it is possible. You can select it and what distance you needed, you can specify it, or it will come. As simple it is. Next, going with the mirror command. Do see that how the mirror commands are possible. Mirror is nothing but an actual mirror. So you have to know that the mirror, it will reflect in the opposite side. If you see that the circle in the top, so if you are doing mirror, automatically it will be on the bottom. So there are two mirror options in Revit. If you can see that MM and DM, for them it is a shortcut. If you have an axis, you can select the axis. If you don't have an axis, you have to use this option. But in this case, we have the common point. So you can select the common point using this mirror option. Automatically, the elements will be mirrored. Select the object, take the mirror command, select two common points. It may overlap with the other file. Nope, not a problem. The elements will be created. Even I can move this downwards a little bit and select this element, mirror, pick two points, the axis you wanted will be done. But in this case, the axis line will be this line. We have existing axis line, so select the element. You can go ahead and use the pick axis option. Pick this option. Automatically, the elements will be mirrored to the other side. If you don't need a copy of the element, you can select this mirror. You can uncheck this copy. Automatically, the existing elements will be deleted and you will have the remaining object. But in this case, it is not only horizontal and vertical. You will be able to do mirror in any direction, any angles. you have to specify the mirror axis in that direction. With that, we have a next option for splitting option. So you can use the offset and trim extend to complete this option. So the split option is available in this place. You can see that it is SL. So before doing that, you have to use the offset command to offset the lines as numerical as 1000. I will use tab key to select continuously, click once again for the second element and this element. Use the trim and extend. Right, in this case I can use multiple trim and extend like this one, and select this one bottom, this side and this side. Looks good, but we need to do trim and extend in this place. If you are doing a trim and extend TR, if I click these two lines, these two lines are needed. The other side will be deleted, so it will be disjoint from this element. It will say you this error. You give undo, unjoin this element, so you will miss this element. You have to redraw this element. You don't have to do that. For that case, we have a split option. Use split command SL. You can split these lines. In AutoCAD it is a break. You can break the line. As similar to that, we have a split command here. Use trim and extend. Do the trim and extend for the corner. That's it. The next option, it is pin and pin. If you see that these rectangles, if I select all together and I can move it wherever I need. So if I say that you can pin this element, you can pin this element. Now you will not be able to move this element. Even if I use this option, I will not be able to select this element. Now I'll have only option to move the other elements. It will increase in the length, but it will not be able to move. If I do unpin, I'll be able to move it. See, this all this modify command not only applicable to line, it is applied to all the elements, such as elements like switches and ducts, pipes. It applies, depends on the element. So mostly we use the pin option for AutoCAD and Revit file linking. So because we don't want to move them once it is fixed, even though the grid, we don't want to move them. So we will accidentally move them. We will pin them once it is finalized. The next option is, which is available, not available in this place. It will show you based on the contextual tab. Based on the selection of the element. For example, in this case, if you see that the one switch which is missing from the wall, you can select the switch. You see that it is not associated. It says it is not associated. So for the other switch, it says its host element, it is basic wall. So similarly, for the other element, it is basic wall. To rehost them, we have to select them, and you will have an option pick new, and you will be able to use the same height automatically, and you can place it wherever you need. For example, this element we don't want in this wall. You can use the pick new and you can place it on the other side of the wall. It will maintain the same property. The usage of this pick new option, it will maintain the same property. It will not lose any property from this. If you are creating the new element, you have to define the height. It may be in a different height or it may be in a different value. You may miss the input value from this property. So it is better that you rehost the element from one place to the other place. So I have matched with the existing one. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope this tutorial helped you to create some option. So I will include this file to you, the website. You can download them and practice it yourself. These are the basic commands, modifying commands applicable to all our practice. So do practice it and let me know if you have any queries in the command. I will try to address them in the next upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching. Do share it with your learning friends. See you on the next tutorial.